I create porcelain and stoneware ceramic goods, mainly for the home, but also for gifts and keepsakes for individuals. The work that I create has been made carefully and slowly. It's something that will last the test of time and be something that will encourage an emotional interaction with the person who owns it. We are custodians of this planet. Everything that we do, we need to make sure is in a fit state to be passed on to the next user, the next generation. And by capturing some of that visually and in these pieces, I hope that that will encourage more people to give consideration to that. And if only one or two people reflect on the beauty of their surroundings and do something to preserve that and conserve that, then I feel it's had impact. The intention behind the making process is to give the owner of that product a chance to really connect with the item, so they'll have some knowledge about the making of that product. They will have an insight into the person who shaped it, the machinery that was involved in molding or firing those goods. So I suppose it's really about slowing down the manufacturing process from being large scale, repetitive, factory driven processes to something that's really been crafted with care, attention to detail, and to make something that hopefully has more depth and a story behind it. I'm hoping that people might want to own one of my products because they see it as being a personal connection to something that they feel. So that might be through the joy they could get from seeing some of the artwork on each piece, or it could be that every time it's used, it makes life a little bit more interesting for them. So it could be that, for instance, a cup of tea poured from a porcelain teapot with words that reflect the place that it was made in just adds something interesting to the process of that everyday activity. So I live in Devon, and I also have connections in some very beautiful parts of the world, so Ireland and Canada. And in the last few years, I've had many opportunities to really study the best parts of those places. And as a watercolourist, I also like the challenge of painting in situ out in those landscapes in order to capture the detail of what I see. So the painting on the porcelain and stoneware pieces has been captured in the wilds and the exposed elements of that setting, and that hopefully comes over through colour. It will come over through the framed context of what I actually choose to paint, and it's for me the opportunity to sit for 45 minutes and to take a rectangle of the landscape and look almost in a sort of pixelated way at what I see and translate that onto paper. It's a sheer joy. And I think, you know, that enjoyment hopefully comes out when you look at that design on the pot. The choice of landscape or seascape or the setting that features on most of the products is chosen very carefully because it has a personal connection for me, and I know through the the interactions I have with other people that go to those places, that it's a very special moment to be at those locations. So, you know, hearing and seeing the things that I do when I paint those pictures or write the words that connect to that setting, I'm almost certain that that connection will filter down through to the person who then owns that product, that they will be reminded of beautiful times that they've had in those places, and it's just a very positive engagement with what they see and what they read on the porcelain in terms of the poetry, that hopefully will engender some real connections for that person and make that item feel less like an inanimate object and more like something that could be cherished and valued in the home and by the owner.